This is A Bit of Biology with Mr. Rock, and today we are going to be talking about greenhouse gases. So before we actually start talking about greenhouse gases, one thing I do want to address is the difference between weather and climate. Okay, so we use the term weather all the time, and we can actually use both of these factors to describe weather and climate. So things like atmosphere, precipitation, temperature, and other environmental things like wind are all used to describe weather, and we can also use all of those things to describe the climate. The difference between the two is that weather is the day-to-day. So what I mean by that is, like, when we talk about the weather, we're talking about tomorrow and what tomorrow's forecast is going to be, whether it's going to be hot, whether it's going to be rainy. Though that is the day-to-day weather description. And an analogy that I like to use is describing the weather as your outfit, because that's what you're wearing on that day. Climate is different just in the length of time. So climate is the yearly average. So an example of this would be your wardrobe. So it is what you, all of the clothes that make up your closet. So the weather is determined by the climate in the same way that your outfit is determined by your wardrobe. So all of the weather that we get is made up of our climate, same way that all of the outfits that you could possibly wear are determined by the wardrobe that you have. So the climate is just over a longer period of time. And another reason why I really like this analogy is because your wardrobe can change. And same thing with the earth, like the earth's climate changes all of the time. So like your climate or your wardrobe is not going to be the same today as it is in 20 years from now. So on to greenhouse gases. If you've ever been to the Como Zoo, you would see a greenhouse at Como Zoo Conservatory. So a greenhouse is a structure that's made up totally of glass. And it allows the sunlight to come in. And the unique thing about it is the glass actually traps in the heat. So the sunlight comes in and the heat tries to leave, but it doesn't. As a result, greenhouses typically tend to be very, very warm, and that is why we use them for growing plants. So the greenhouse effect does not describe a structure or a building, it actually describes our earth. And it's the process at which the atmosphere traps in the heat. So the sun comes in and the heat tries to leave, but then we have these gases in our atmosphere that actually trap in the heat. Now, this is greenhouse gases and climate change can be a controversial topic. However, nobody right now is really disputing if greenhouse gases are a thing. We all agree that greenhouse gases are a thing. We're just debating over the effect that they're having. So greenhouse gases are actually really, really good, and they've been around long before humans were even here. So they're good. However, the problem is that we are starting to personally add too many greenhouse gases to our atmosphere. And that's a problem, because if we add too much greenhouse gas, then our Earth's temperature is going to start to get too warm. So you might know some of these greenhouse gases. They've probably been talked about a lot. Carbon dioxide is the most commonly discussed one. And they come from car exhaust. They come from cellular respiration. So you breathe out carbon dioxide all the time. And we also get them from burning fossil fuels and burning rainforests. So carbon is released into the air, and that's a greenhouse gas. Another form of carbon is actually methane, and we get this methane, it's produced from oxygen-deprived areas. So examples of this would be something like a landfill, where you have these huge mounds of garbage, and underneath it all, there's no oxygen in there. So as a result, methane is produced, and that's a greenhouse gas. We also get this from agriculture, commonly known as cow farts and human farts. Our digestive systems are oxygen deprived, so we also fart out, as do cows, we fart out methane, which is a greenhouse gas. Water vapor is another one. This is not produced by humans, but it actually comes off of bodies of water. However, the amount of evaporation increases with warmer temperatures. And then the final one is nitrous oxide, which comes from car exhaust. So this is a map showing carbon dioxide emissions over the last 400,000 years. So one thing I do want to point out, within the last 100 years, our carbon dioxide emissions have gone way up. And that is because of things like the Industrial Revolution. We are driving more cars, we're producing more agriculture than we ever have, and the CO2 is going way up. As a result, we are seeing temperatures, global temperatures, also increase because, and that's what the science, that's what global gases, I mean, sorry, greenhouse gases would say, is that the more greenhouse gases you put on the atmosphere, the warmer the earth is going to get because the greenhouse gases just kind of act as a blanket. So we're putting more CO2 into our atmosphere, which is causing our earth to get warmer and warmer. So then the problem with this then becomes a couple of things. And these are not ranked in severity, like it's not like number one's the worst, but they're just kind of problems that we're starting to see. So number one, we have rising sea levels. There are cities that are starting to get flooded constantly because the warmer temperatures are causing ice caps to melt, and that is causing our sea levels to rise. Another problem is because we're getting more acidic oceans because there's more CO2 in our atmosphere. More CO2 is dissolving into the ocean, causing it to be more acidic, and more acidic water makes it harder for marine life. So things like sea anemones and coral reefs, they are not surviving right now. They're actually dying at a very fast rate because our oceans are becoming more and more acidic. Warmer global temperatures actually just cause overall just a problem for plants and animals. I don't know if anybody gardens or takes care of plants here, but like too hot of temperatures for plants is problematic. And plants actually can die if they get too hot. And same thing with animals. Like we have increased temperatures, and this increases stress and harsher living conditions for both plants and animals. And finally, the last one, more severe natural disasters and storms. We are seeing more and more hurricanes and more, I guess not even more, but more severity with them. And this is because the heat is displaced in wind and ocean currents. So more heat is being carried through the wind, more heat is being carried through ocean currents. And as a result, it's causing more and more harsher, severe natural disasters. This is actually really costly, and something that I'll just throw out there is a lot of people don't know about Isle de Jean Charles, which is in Louisiana. They are the first city that is migrating. They have to totally leave their city because of climate change. So they're the first, they're calling them the climate change refugees. The government is actually taking on the cost of relocating this whole entire city, and they're estimating it to be about $52 million to move everybody off of this coastline, which is really crazy. This has been A Bit of Biology with Mr. Rock. I'm signing off.